Hello and welcome to this session on how to make your code modular. Today we are going to learn how do we separate our code as per the actions or the functionalities we are doing in our code, and we will look at some useful tips. Let us begin. The very first step is we have to create our functions based on the actions we are doing. So let us go to our Eclipse, and this is the program that we have written in our earlier sessions. And in case you have not watched the earlier sessions, I will request you to please go and watch them, because this is going to be a continuation from there. So this is the function we had written, and you can see everything is inside the main method. So all our statements are inside the main method, which is not very good. So let us first try to find out what are the actions we are doing. The very first action is we are setting the configuration for the browser, and even before that we have to tell what browser we have to use. So we have to tell what is the browser we are going to use in our test, then based on that browser we have to set the configuration, and then finally run our test on that browser and configurations. So let me write down these three actions. We are setting browser. So one action is set browser, second action is set browser configuration, and the third action is run test. Okay, so these are the three actions we are doing. So let us create functions based on these actions. So I will say public static void set browser should be one function, and it should be a separate function, and then public static void set browser config should be another function. So I'm creating a separate function for this. And then again public static void run test. So our test should also be running in a separate function. Okay, so these are the three simple actions we are doing, and I have created three functions for this. So this was our step one. Step two is we have to copy the required code from the main methods to these functions. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to cut our code from here and put it inside our separate functions. So the very first function is set browser, which actually we were not doing. We were always commenting out the browser that we are not using and then adding the browser that we were using. So we will create a string here. I'll say string browser equal to whatever browser we want to use. So let us say we want to use Firefox. Okay, now the other thing is, because this browser is a variable and it is present inside this function, so the other functions cannot see it. So if I want to check which is the browser and add some configuration in set browser configuration, I cannot see this function, cannot see this browser variable. So for that I have to make it a public variable. So I will keep it outside all the functions inside the class. I will say string browser. So I have made it a class variable, and I can also say static so that it is fixed and available to all the programs. And now I can delete string from here. So now you can see browser is now a class variable, and if I set it as Firefox, even other functions can see it and make their conditions accordingly. Now the second is we have to set browser configuration. So all these statements that were doing the browser configuration, I will cut it from the main method, and I am just going to copy it here. And to make the indentation proper, you can select everything and press Ctrl I or Command I in case you are on Mac. And now what I'm going to do is I will put all the Firefox related configurations together. So all these are Firefox related configurations and all the Chrome related configurations in a single block. And now I'm going to uncomment everything. So earlier we were always commenting out and uncommenting whenever we used to change the browser, but now you can see these are the configurations for Firefox and these are the configurations for Chrome. So now I can put a single condition here, and I can say if browser equals equals, or I can also say dot contains. So you will get these options. Just wait for a moment. Yeah, dot contains, and I can put here Firefox. So this is the browser that it is taking from here, whatever we have set. If it contains Firefox, then do these configurations, and if browser dot contains Chrome, then we have to do these configurations. And also here you can see this driver is created again and again. We are creating it here and then again here. So again, we can keep it also as a class variable. So I will go to the top, and here I can again make this driver object, and I can make it static again. So now I do not have to instantiate it every time, so I can remove it from here, directly use driver, and here as well. So now you can see this function is setting up the browser configurations as per the browser we have set in our first function. And now the only thing left is run test. So these are the two statements which are running our test. I will cut it from here again and put it inside our run test method, and that's it. Now you can see our code is so much clean. There are three simple functions which are doing everything. And now the third step is we have to call these functions from the main method, because the starting point of every Java program is main. So now we have to call it from here, and I will call it in sequence. First one is set browser. You can press control spacebar, it will give you the name. Second one is set browser configuration, this one. Third one is run test, this one. So we are now calling these methods from main in sequence. Okay, so now the fourth step is just we have to run and validate. So let me keep my browser as Firefox here, do a right click, run as Java application, and it should run my test on a Firefox browser. Let us wait. Yeah, it has started the execution, and yes, it is calling the Firefox browser. So it has started the test, the Firefox browser, and it is going to the Selenium HQ website and close the browser. Now let us validate our test by using Chrome. So I'm just making the change here and not anywhere else. I will do a right click, run as Java application, and now it is running the same test on a Chrome browser. So our test is successful, and in the coming sessions we will also see how we can pass this browser from an external file, so we do not have to even do this change from our code and everything is handled externally. But for now, this is what we have to do, and these are the four simple steps that we have used to make our code modular. Let us look at some useful tips. You should always create a separate method for every separate functionality. So whenever you see a separate action, you should have a separate function for that. It will make your code very much readable, modular, and it will help you to do changes and enhance your code, because it will be very simple to do that when your code is modular and is in separate functions. Second thing is we have to add comments wherever applicable or useful. So here you can add function comments. You can say forward slash double star and hit enter, and here you can give the description of the method, what it is doing. You can put the author name, you can put the date, and so on. And in case you want to add comments within the functions, you can put double forward slash and write anything. So for example, I can write here this condition block sets configurations for Firefox browser. So you should always write comments wherever you think it's applicable, because it will make your code very readable, very useful. It will make it very understandable for others and for you as well. When it gets older and you will come back, you will find it very useful that you have comments in your codes. This is a website that I found very useful, and if you go here, it is very good for beginners and there are some useful tips. Keep classes small, name methods carefully, so do not name your methods like 1, 2, A, B, test 1, test 2 and so on. Give some meaningful names as per the actions being done in the method. Keep methods small, use comments wherever applicable, use a consistent style. So if you are following this style of writing methods, always use this style, do not keep on changing your style. Use built-in logging, that means you can put system.out.println statements wherever you think it will be helpful to debug your code. And these are some useful tips. Please go through it. Let us see a very quick recap. Today we learned how we can separate our code into separate actions and then create a function per action, and we have looked at some useful tips. I hope this session was very useful for you. In case you have any comments or any doubts or any questions, please do write them down in the comment section. I will meet you in the next section. Thanks for watching.